In today's video, we're going to be talking about a little thing known as feature creep. So what is feature creep? It's best if I just give you an example. You've got your RPG. In that RPG, you have a battle system with weapons. If you've got weapons, then maybe you can upgrade those weapons. Maybe you can mine for the materials, and when you mine the ore, you can then use that ore to smelt the metal and use that metal to make the weapons. But now that you've made the weapons and upgraded the weapons, what if you could enchant the weapons? You include a system in your game where you can enchant the weapons that you've crafted. And you know what else would be cool? A relationship system where the main character can have relations with the supporting characters. And then on top of that, if the relationship levels get high enough, you can make them have babies. Let's not just stop with the main characters, because we've already crafted these weapons, how about we pair two weapons together, and those weapons, once paired together, have a baby weapon, and that baby weapon and one of the human babies can form together to become a human weapon. And then you could also have a transport system like a taxi, and the players can catch taxis from one city to another. But if players can catch taxis, there seems to be no reason why the players shouldn't also be able to own a car, so you should be able to drive a car and then drive around to different cities yourself. Let's not stop there though, let's have it so the players have the ability to buy the taxi company and they can make passive income while they've got little workers driving other adventurers around the game. And then you could have a system where your company competes with other taxi companies, and then your company wins because you can upgrade the cars, so you mine materials and you can upgrade your cars, and then you can magically enchant your cars. You could even enter them in like car races, but if there are car races, then wouldn't it be cool if we had a gambling system so you could bet on races, not just cars, like cars, horses, dogs? Wouldn't it be cool if we had an entire gambling system within our game? And if you have a gambling system, then of course you're going to have a casino, so you could build an entire casino with lots of different casino mini games. But what about representing daytime and nighttime? We could have a day-night system where some things are open at daytime and some things are open at nighttime. And the adventurers can only do things during the daytime, but there are sometimes they have to wait until nighttime. Linking back to our mining system, maybe some of the only craftable materials that you can find appear during night are some of the rarest ones you can find, but there are also tougher monsters at nighttime. But because there's such tough monsters in the world, surely there's a guild that's hunting all the tough monsters. So you can put a guild in where you can hunt all of these tough monsters. You have to hunt a whole bunch of them. And when you hunt them all, you become the leader of the guild. And because you're the leader of the guild, you get this cool new costume for your character. But you shouldn't just have to be the leader of a guild to get a costume. You should be able to go down to the shops and buy a costume. So you have a shop in your game where you can buy different costumes and equip all of your different party members with different costumes. And then you have player housing, a place where your player can store all of these costumes so they can go home and change. And then we can have a system in the game where we buy a house and then renovate a house so you can change the different looks of the house for your player. You can start off with like a poor simple house and then work your way up to having a mansion. And because you have a mansion, you're going to want to have parties at the mansion. So we should have this system in our game where you can throw parties at the mansion and then a bunch of people come and you can increase your relationship level with all the people at the party. You could even have a random chance event that like the town guard or the cops get called to the party. We should also have like a crime and law system, so it's not just the party, but like if your players do something wrong in the game, then the cops are actually coming after them. There's this whole system where the cops chase you down for every warrant you have. And we could even have a system where you become the cop and you go around as like a side quest and you chase down people with different warrants, like a bounty hunter. But then wouldn't it be cool if you could be a criminal? We should have some sort of stealth system in the game where you can break into people's houses and steal all their stuff, and if you get caught, then you get like stars like in Grand Theft Auto. And then you could have like a time travel system in your game, so like when you buy the taxi company, you can go back in time and sabotage your competitor's taxi company. Wouldn't it be cool to have this whole little mini game side quest around sabotaging your enemy taxi company? But if there's competing companies in this world, then there's probably a stock system. So wouldn't it be cool if the players could buy and sell stocks to make money? Wouldn't it be cool? Wait, what's my game about again? Feature creep is where someone just keeps adding new features that they think would be cool for the game. They add feature after feature because it'd be a cool feature, but they lose sight of the original intent of their game. You don't need all those features in an RPG where the hero saves the world from some demigod. Don't get me wrong, you can have features, but your game doesn't have to have every single feature under the sun. And I see this happen a lot with people. They keep trying to add feature after feature, and they spend so much time working on all the different features of their game that they don't work on their game. Being a solo dev is tedious work. It's long, hard, and tedious. Don't worry about adding all of these features that you think will make your game cool. The biggest thing you should worry about is making your game. Now, yes, I make lots of different videos about all these different features you could have in your game. I make these videos to give you ideas on things you could do in your game, but never would I recommend you implement every single feature that I make a video about. What you want to be focusing on is the MVP, and that stands for Most Valuable Player, which is you, but it also stands for Minimum Viable Product. Your game doesn't have to look pretty. You just need a game that plays from beginning to middle to end. And then once you've done that, you've got a game. You've got an MVP. After you've got your minimum viable product, that's when you can add in different features, as long as it doesn't detract from the main purpose of your game. If you finish your game and you want to add something in, cool, add it in and see if it works with your game. If it doesn't, you can take it out. There is absolutely no reason you should be trying to add 20 and 30 different features in the middle of your game's development. Just make your MVP. By the way, you guys really are MVPs. Why? Because those of you who haven't yet are gonna scroll down and subscribe. And if you really like this video, then you're also gonna hit the like button. And another thing which makes you guys MVPs is you're also going to click on this video right here, which talks about whether save points are necessary or useless. Thank you for watching, and I will see you MVPs in the next video.